Civil Liberties Committee voted on a new and updated counter-terrorism directive. What new initiatives are being taken?
The new initiatives are that if somebody is participating on a training for terrorist purposes or traveling for terrorist purposes in conflict zones or coming back to the European Union, if somebody is helping to do a lot of propaganda for terrorist networks and help terrorist networks with financing or organization, facilitation. And one very important point for the European Parliament was the support of victims. We have introduced much more than that was foreseen because we had a lot of dialogues and conversations with the organizations of victims of terrorism, and we see that there is a lot to do.
What sort of measures are you taking to help victims?
First, there is the free legal assistance. Victims need legal help. They need information center, and we ask for if there a huge terrorist attack is happening, then you need a coordination center where people can ask where their family members are, where their friends are. So there is more organization, more financial meanings for the victims necessary, because we should speak more about the victims and not only about the criminals.
The new directive also tackles how the internet supports terrorism. What measures can you take here to protect European citizens?
It is not the internet itself, because the internet is neutral, but the misuse of internet, as you can misuse several other things, you can misuse the internet as distributor of messages of information that are forbidden. So propaganda and instigation are forbidden, must be punished if they are done for terrorist purposes, for example, for recruitment of young people to commit a terrorist attack, or to glorify terrorist attackers as heroes, or to try to earn money via the internet. So there are several issues that are under the restriction of the new directive.
Your committee has taken quite a strong stance on mass surveillance, and in particular opposition to mass surveillance, and has been supporting encryption. What would you say needs to be done in this area? Is it okay to survey EU citizens en masse, or do we need to take a more nuanced response?
I think the word mass surveillance is not a technical term, so it's not clarified. This is the reason why it does not appear in this directive, because mass surveillance, for example, in Brussels, you had cameras. This is a kind of mass surveillance, but by the way, these cameras took photos of the terrorists and they are needed. So you always need the balance in between the freedom of the individual for freedom of expression, freedom to travel and everything. And on the other side, the security side, we have the duty to prohibit any terrorist attack as it is possible by any way and by any means. So we try to do the balance. In the individual case, it depends on the case what the security institutions together with the justice systems are doing. This was the reason why we talked a lot with Eurojust and with judges and with prosecutors before the decision in our LIBE committee, before we negotiated the compromises, to have a firm common position of our committee to fight and to strike back the terrorism.
On the financing of terrorism, does the European Parliament need to work with other committees in order to ensure that terrorists do not use vehicles like shell companies and the cover of tax havens that don't publish ownership of their companies? What can be done at this end, either within this directive or by other directives?
So first, the terrorism directive is dealing with the issue of financing for terrorist purposes. So if somebody is supporting a terrorist network, this is covered by the terrorist directive, terrorism directive. There are other directives like anti-money laundering. This will be presented in these days. So there the Libe Committee works together with the Econ Committee. The Econ Committee is the one that is responsible for all the economic issues and financial issues. And there are especially the issues of financing that is done in a way that is very, very clever. They sell art goods, they sell oil, gold, diamonds. Terrorists make use of everything. They are very clever in that. They make use of Bitcoin, they make use of everything that is possible, they are where they feel that they are safe in the financial flows. So we ask for really having a very, very strong legislation following back and tracing back the money flow. Because we want to know who has sold, for what purposes an art good, who has sold oil, who is behind a construction of 10 or 12 companies with no names behind. So we want that clear names are given if financial flows are big or are interesting in certain cases of organized crime or terrorism.